name's Trili. I work at Olympus as a repair scheduler in the service department. I've been at Olympus for 3 years now, and I work in the MedTech industry for about 10 years.
My name's Alex. At Olympus, I'm a live specialist in our Melbourne centre. I've been with Olympus for 2 years now, and this is my first MedTech role.
My name's James. I'm the L&D business partner here at Olympus. I've been here for 3 years, and this is actually my first time working for a MedTech company.
I'm Michelle. I work in the communications department as a social media and communications specialist. I've been in the MedTech industry at Olympus for 7 years.
So we work in the MedTech space. That has a vast majority of roles you can do. What are your roles and your day-to-day look like?
Well, my role is a repair scheduler in the service department. So predominantly, I work with our service technicians, repair technicians, repairing scopes mostly, and basically I would allocate them jobs and ensure that the scope is repaired back to the customer on time.
From an L&D perspective, there's a bit of a distance between what goes on the ground versus what happens in the office, but it's rolling out training to the team.
With my role as a live specialist in our Melbourne centre, I'm meeting with customers who are coming through to get education and training on our medical scopes. So making sure that they're having a good time while they're in the centre here, and we're strengthening our relationships with them while they're getting that education and training.
Being in communication, I get to see what you guys get up to with customers and see how we can interact with patients and doctors and, you know, patient outcomes and that sort of thing in a corporate communication space. What attracted you to this as a role?
I've always been really interested in health, so that was a pathway that I actually chose to actually explore the health side of the industry, and from there it sort of developed into MedTech or medical devices. So I've actually been in MedTech for about 10 years now and just sort of came across Olympus as a really reputable and prestigious company, so decided to go for it.
I didn't actually know much about MedTech going into Olympus. Obviously the brand's really strong in cameras, but obviously now that I know a lot more about MedTech, I just love how fast paced it is, how you're constantly on your toes, and the end result is, you know, pleasing customers, people who are in a hospital who need help. So it's just nice knowing that that's always the end game for everything that we do, regardless of what your job is in the business.
Yeah, it's quite fulfilling.
Yeah, and I guess I'm similar to you, James. I really knew Olympus for its photography. I was in the photography sector before Olympus, but getting the role here, learning how much the MedTech is a big part of Olympus as a company, I've really grown to love that section of Olympus. It's become one of my favourite parts about it.
How amazing some of the stories that you hear as well, like from just like the sales reps and things, you know, from our monthly catch-ups we have as a business where you hear about these stories, like it really kind of spurs you on like day to day in terms of what you're doing.
I think that for me is quite fulfilling in itself. It's giving you a purpose because, you know, being in corporate, you don't necessarily always think of that when you're typing in an email as an example, but when you kind of see that is in a body of other work that then goes into a patient who has an early diagnosis because of a product, or more accurate diagnosis, which means better treatment.
And I think it's just really important, especially when you talk to customer operations where they have a direct communication line to the customer who, you know, calls up to say, oh, I've got a really urgent case and we need our scope back on time because there is going to be a patient on the table, and you just work so hard to get that customer ready and prepped to go so that they can actually have that patient on the table ready to go. So I think that's just really important, and, you know, with everything that we do, like it has a direct impact to a patient.
I think definitely with our customers coming through here and getting training on our scopes and how to use them, and just seeing how much they appreciate Olympus putting in the time to do that training with them instead of just selling them a product and they have to then figure it out by themselves. They're always so appreciative that we give them that time to really make sure that they know how to use that product on the patients correctly so that there's not going to be any complications within those procedures. That was my moment, definitely. Yeah.
James, coming into this as a graduate, like, and sort of not knowing what to expect, what was your biggest surprise or challenge?
I think the biggest surprise was just how cross-functional it is. Like Olympus is a really well-oiled machine, and I think maybe We surprise ourselves with just how well we work as a business, cross-functionally. You've got the sales team that have to constantly touch base with the marketing team, with the service team, and just amazing to see it all kind of come together with the one goal of really helping our customers.
Coming into the medical industry, it's really been such an eye-opener to different procedures and different things that are going on in the space, all the different technology. And to be part of a company that's at the forefront of that technology, it's a really great feeling to be in that environment. It's really exciting.
I know a lot of people in Olympus have started in a customer ops role and then have moved into sales and all clinical trainers and that sort of stuff.
How many times have you moved?
Yeah, this is my fourth department.
I think our generation would be pretty oblivious to, I think you spoke to the cutting edge technology side of med tech, which would be really appealing to them. You think of phones, you think of apps, you think of, coding and things like that, but there's just so much to really promote within med tech, and hopefully stuff like this helps with that, because you want people to come into med tech, especially the younger generation, and really refresh it, which is amazing.
I guess like that myself, I was always, oh, when's the new camera coming out, or what's this now? I'm like, when's the new scope coming out?
When's the new platform?
Yeah, exactly.
Being part of the med tech industry, I think that fulfills that part of it for me, where even though I'm not in the healthcare industry, I'm not a HCP, where I'm a surgeon or I'm a nurse, but my day-to-day work helps the hospitals function and helps patients get their treatment and things like that. So I think for me, that's the core piece of why I've stayed in the medtech industry for such a long time.
There's so much to learn. There's so much to do in medtech. It's so exciting. If you're thinking about a career in medtech, I would say go for it. And just see what you can do in there, because there's so many opportunities.
My biggest fear was I don't have a medical background, so why would I go into something like this? But being in it, you learn so much, and everybody is there to help you and teach you. There is not one person I've met in this space that hasn't gone, oh, do you need help with this, or I can help teach you something new. So I think you actually come out of it learning so much more than you would have ever imagined. Being in medtech, what sticks out to you the most?
Certainly how fast-paced the industry is, but also not knowing what's around the corner. I think what's really exciting is you see things like artificial intelligence, robotics, machine learning, things like that that are really coming to the forefront.
I definitely agree with that. Things like artificial intelligence you see popping up everywhere. It's on our phones, it's coming into the medical industry, and I think that's a really exciting way that we're going to be able to diagnose things with so much more accuracy than what we've been able to do before. Just seeing how that's going to change people's lives is going to be really exciting, I think.
I went to a MedTech conference recently where Mayo Clinic was there, and they were talking about their digital space. They weren't really talking so much about their hospital, their physical hospital, but more a digital hospital where people can go and show a skin colour, and it'll roughly give them, this is what you could be experiencing, and this is sort of different things you can do. And I think that's great for accessibility for people who can't always go to a hospital or go into the doctor.
Even in a couple of years ago, we wouldn't be able to, show such a sharp image of, our insides, and now we've got 3D technology that's coming out, and we can see, where things actually are.
It's amazing to see when surgeons do use the 3D technology, which gives them that such a better depth perception doing their surgeries. And just hearing them talk about how beneficial that is to them and also their patients, because it's reducing the patient's time on the bed. They're able to recover quicker. They're getting a better procedure done, and it's a real eye-opener, and it's really great to see.
Imagine if you were a part of the reason that you have a cure for cancer. Like, that's pretty mind-blowing if you just stop and think about that. That's something that would be very incredible, and you have to be in an industry like this to be part of something like that.
Absolutely.
Part of changing the world.